Hello, my name is Rohit Kumar Thakur and in this video I will demonstrate how gyroscope sensors work in React Native Expo applications. So let's dive right into it and create our Expo app. Start by selecting the blank template and providing a name for your application. Once that's done, we can proceed with downloading the necessary dependencies. For those who are unfamiliar with gyroscope sensors in mobile phones, they are responsible for measuring the device's orientation. They can detect motion including vertical and horizontal rotation. Many of you have used the gyroscope while playing the games like PUBG. However, today, we will be using the gyroscope to move a ball. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and follow me on social media to be a part of our developer community. To begin, let's install the Expo sensors package using the official command. You can find the command displayed on the screen. The Expo also provides some official code for you to check out and try. However, we will be building something unique in this tutorial. So let's get started. Create a separate file named index.js inside a source folder. In this file, we will create a basic UI component and import it into app.js. To ensure everything is working smoothly, run the project and test it out. Now for the project, first, the necessary dependencies and components are imported. These include view, text, styleset, switch and safe area view from the React Native library, as well as React, useEffect and useState from the React library. Additionally, the gyroscope functionalities is imported from the Expo sensors package. Next, a functional component called gyroscreen is defined. This component represents the screen where the gyroscope data will be displayed and the user can toggle the gyroscope sensor. Inside this component, two state variables are declared using the useState hook, gyroData and gyroEnabled. The gyroData state variable holds the object with initial values of x0, y0 and z0. This object will be updated from the gyroscope data received from the device. The gyro-enabled state variable is initially set to false and will be used to enable or disable the gyroscope sensor. The useEffect hook is used to handle the life cycle of the component. It takes a function as its first parameter and an array of dependencies as its second parameter. The function inside the useEffect hook will be called whenever the gyro enabled state variable changes. Inside the useEffect hook, a local variable called subscription is declared. If the gyro enabled state variable is true, a listener is added to the gyroscope using the gyroscope.addListener. This listener receives gyroscope data and updates the gyro data state variable with the received data using the set gyro data. If the gyro enabled state variable is false, the listener is removed using the subscription.remove. The useEffect hook also returns a cleanup function. This function will be called when the component is unmounted or when the gyro enabled state variable changes. Inside the cleanup function, the listener is removed to avoid memory leaks using subscription.remove. Next, a function called handleGyroToggle is defined. It toggles the value of gyro enabled state variable using the set gyro enabled. The gyro screen component returns JSX. It is wrapped in a safe area view component from the React Native to ensure that the content fits within the visible area of the screen. Inside the safe area view, there is a text component with the title gyroscope and a view component that contains a switch component. The switch component allows the user to toggle the gyroscope sensor on or off. It has various style properties defined using the style object, such as track color, thumb color, and iOS background color, which determine the appearance of the switch. Finally, there is another view component that represents a colored circle. It has a width and height of 100 units, a border radius of 50 units to create a circular shape, and a background color of red. The circle's position is manipulated based on the gyroscope data received. The transform property is used to apply translations to the circle using the gyro data values. The gyro data dot y into 10 value is used to translate the circle horizontally, and the minus gyro data dot x multiply by 10 value is used to translate it vertically. Notice how the red ball on the screen dynamically moves as I tilt the device. This interactive demonstration showcases the functionality of the gyroscope. But this is just the start. There are endless possibilities for gyro-based projects. If you have a specific gyro project in mind, be sure to leave a comment and let us know. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and follow us on social media to become a part of our vibrant developer community. Stay tuned for our next React Native Expo video. See you there.